Hi, welcome to this video. In this video, I will be talking about two sample t-tests for independent samples. The population variances for population 1 and population 2 are unknown, and we're assuming unequal population variances. We will be looking at the following example. The management of a bank is interested in knowing whether there is a significant difference in the population mean ages of the customers that bank at two different locations. The ages of a sample of customers at two different bank locations were recorded and are provided below. Test the claim using alpha equals to 1%. Also assume unequal population variances. Our data is given in this table. We are going to start off by writing the null and alternative hypothesis. The claim in this question is there is a significant difference in the population mean ages. So as a result of that, my claim will be the alternative hypothesis. My null hypothesis will be mu 1 is equal to mu 2, or mu 1 minus mu 2 is equal to 0. My alternative, which is the claim, will be mu 1 is not equal to mu 2, or mu 1 minus mu 2 is not equal to 0. We will now be going into Excel to analyze using data analysis. Once the data is in Excel, we will click on Data, Data Analysis, and on the list we'll look for t-test two sample assuming unequal variances. And then we click OK. Highlight the first column for branch 1. And for variable 2, we will highlight the second column. And then for the hypothesized mean difference, we have 0. And for alpha, we have 1%, 0.01. And then we click OK. The output shows up in this window. The first thing we need to look at will be the test statistic. The test statistic is right here. We would also see information about the p-value and the critical value. Since it's two-tailed, this will be the p-value and this will be the critical value. But sometimes Excel gives us wrong answers for the critical value. So we would quickly check that. We can either use the t-distribution table or we go to any cell in Excel and type equal to t.inv, which shows up. And then since it's the two-tailed test, we're going to select .2t. Alpha here is 0.01. The degrees of freedom is 14. So my critical value here should be 2.977. So we should pay attention to that. The other thing that we can find here manually, we can also use Excel here to find the p-value rather than reading it off from the output. We go to any cell and type equal to t.dist. And then in here, we're going to be putting the test statistics and then comma the degrees of freedom, which is 14, comma, true, because it's cumulative. The result we obtain here will be for the one-tailed, but because we have a two-tailed test here, we would have to multiply this result by 2 to be able to get the p-value for the two-tailed test. So this value will be approximately 0, so which is very close to what we may have also from the table. We're going to use this result to perform our hypothesis test. Again, from the table, we see that our test statistic is negative 5.336 and our p-value is approximately 0. So we have those two values that we're going to be using to make our decision. If we compare the p-value to alpha, we will see that the p-value is less than alpha. So we'll reject the null hypothesis. The next thing I want us to quickly see is how to get this test statistic if we wanted to compute manually. If we wanted to compute manually, you may be given a question that gives you the summary statistics. Now, to be able to get this value, the test statistic, we will be using this formula right here. So if we put in all the values that we get, you know, from the table here, we have the summary statistics. Or if those values were given to you in a particular question, we just need to put them into the formula and we will be arriving at the same test statistic. So now that we know our test statistic, we can make our decision. We see that the test statistic here falls in the rejection region since it is less than the critical value. Here we are looking at the left tail. So because of that, our critical value is greater than the test statistic, so we reject the null hypothesis. Again, based on the fact that the p-value is less than alpha and we are rejecting the null hypothesis, we can conclude that at 5% level of significance, we have sufficient evidence to support the claim. Thank you so much for watching this video.